Good morning. One of the stories that Jesus tells is an interesting story. It's about two men. And it's interesting because Jesus actually names them, Dives and Lazarus. Now, most people Jesus talks about, he says, a landowner, a father, this person, a servant, or anything else. They're just general names. But on this occasion, Jesus actually gives them names, and many theologians wonder whether, in fact, they were real people that Jesus had once known, living in the area where he was ministering. The one a very wealthy man, the other a poor beggar lying at his gate. And they both die. The beggar, you know, Jesus said, blessed are the poor, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The beggar, trusting in God for all that he had, because he had nothing in this world, is welcomed into Abram's bosom. The rich man, having misused the property he'd been given and all the wealth he'd been given, well, he's cast into the other part of Hades where there was great suffering. And looking up from that part, he sees Lazarus in Abram's bosom and he calls out and he says, Father Abram, would you send Lazarus so that he can just dip his finger in water, because I'm in anguish here in this flame. Abram looks at him and says, I can't do that. There's a gap between us. You in your lifetime, well, you received good things. Lazarus, he received nothing. But now this gap has been placed, and he cannot come to you, because he cannot cross to you like you cannot cross to us. And then it comes the really interesting part of the story. Because the rich man who is now in this torment turns to Abram and says, well, if he can't come to me, would you just send him to my father's house? Because I got five brothers. And if he goes to them and warns them about what might come, then they will repent. And Abram looks towards him and says, no, he says, they got Moses and the prophets, let them listen to them. And he says, no, Father Abram, but if someone rises from the dead. See, this is the interesting point, because what is happening is that the rich man in torment is trying to blame God for what has happened to him. Now, if only God would do something, you know, then people would repent. If only God would really reveal himself to people, then people would repent. And he's told quite simply, no. People will not repent. Even if someone rises from the dead, they will not repent. Now, at the present day, as you go around the world, one of the things I'm fascinated by is to see how many chapels and churches exist, both in the towns and even in the small villages. You may travel on the train, you see a small village sitting in the distance, and there in the middle of the village, there's the spire, there's the church, a small building that people occupy and come and worship. If you start recognizing them, you find that they're everywhere, a perpetual declaration of who God is. And many of them have notices outside saying what time the services are on. Some have sort of Bible verses printed on sheets outside declaring eternal truths. And people walk past them over and over again. They never ever think about what they mean. These are, in a sense, like sermons in stone. This, in a sense, is what Jesus is trying to show through this story. That no matter how much evidence is given, however often the gospel is preached, however many ways we may find of preaching it, most people will just keep their fingers in their ears because they don't want to hear and they don't want to see. I remember in one of my last parishes, I was speaking to a young man on one occasion, and he was living about 200 yards away from the church where I was ministering at that time. And I happened to meet him out and we were talking socially. And I mentioned to him the church. Now, the church was left open day and night. And all the time there was a light left on, the church was left heated so people could go into the church. This young man was about 27, 28 years of age. And I happened to mention the church to him. And he said, oh, yes, he said, I've seen the church as I walked past. I said, have you ever entered it? He said, no. I said, well, the doors are always open. Yes, I know, he said, the doors are always open. He'd lived there for 28 years, just 200 yards from the church. But he had never, ever got into that building. Curiosity had not brought him past the doors. And I began to wonder then what one would have to do to get through to people like this and explain it to them. Well, the rich man in Hades is saying the same thing, you see, to Abraham. He's saying, if only God would do something. Well, God is doing something. He is making a declaration. He is speaking to the world. He's speaking to the world through books, through newspapers, through magazines, through buildings. He's proclaiming to the world over and over again the truth of the gospel. But people will not hear because they don't want to. Amen.